I think the beauty of the medical physics field is that, again, you have an opportunity to bring all of those skills to solve complex problems into an area where you are helping patients, helping individuals to get better. And medical physics field in radiation oncology offers that opportunity every day.
When I came to Mayo Clinic, it was a big choice for me, and I thought it was really, really an exciting place to come for proton therapy that's being developed here. The physics group is fantastic. They're very supportive, they're forward-thinking, they love technology, and they're not afraid to co-develop it with the physicians. Again, it's for clinical use, it's to make our patient care better. We're always willing to adapt, and one of the things about the Proton Center here has been that they made it so that it's upgradable.
One of the main reasons that I was so drawn to Mayo and still appreciate working here is the availability and expertise of people in our other disciplines. You know, these are the people that literally write the textbooks for neurosurgery, that are the world experts, and they're humble, approachable Midwesterners that you can literally call on the phone and say, hey, what do you think about this patient? The access to world experts also makes it so you can collaborate from a research perspective and do things that are really hard to do elsewhere.
I think here at Mayo, we are lucky that since the very beginning, we have that freedom. Any resident can go and knock on any physician's door and ask questions, and actually allows them to, again, feel that they can develop that partnership with a physician for clinical aspects as well as for any research endeavors.
Dr. Nadia Locke and I received a R01 grant to explore the impact of using imaging with an amino acid PET tracer on neurosurgical and radiotherapy planning for glioma patients. We would not have been able to get that grant or do that work without the contributions from a variety of medical physics residents.
We're a three-year program. One of the reasons we have that extra year is to be able to integrate in a lot of research experience. The research we do here at Mayo Clinic tends to be research that's sort of last mile to the patient. Conceptually, the idea is well established, but now you've got to get it to the point that that new technology makes it into the treatment room, and then we verify that that new technology is actually beneficial to the patient. So they learn how to work with those mixed responsibilities and allocate their time appropriately. We think our three-year program is fantastic training for those kinds of junior faculty positions.
When I was applying for residencies, I was looking for a program where I could get the most well-rounded experience possible. So Mayo has a wide variety of equipment, wide variety of research going on, and I was also interested in the fact that it's a three-year program to have that additional opportunity for research.
As a medical physicist, I think you do have the opportunity to work with many, many technologies, like a linear accelerator, we have a proton delivery system, we have a brachytherapy practice, we have an IORT. As a medical physicist, you also have the opportunity to work with many tools that you can possibly imagine as a medical physicist.
I think one of the strongest aspects of our program is our ability to independently cover in the clinic once we've gone through the corresponding rotation and passed a credentialing exam. So we're able to cover SBRT cases independently. For example, we sign off on plans after our first year. This is a unique aspect of our program that I think really prepares us to enter the job market and have that independence experience during our training, always knowing that there's support here if we do have questions.
One of the aspects of our program that also makes us stand out is the faculty to training ratio. For every resident we have three board certified physicists that are participating in the training. I haven't done the analysis to see how that compares with other programs, but I guarantee you it's on the very high side compared to other programs.
For many, many years, the recruitment for medical physics residents was chaotic. Medical residents, on the other hand, had a matching program that's been very, very successful. We decided that we wanted to have a similar program. Mayo Clinic allowed me to try to work with other programs to try to get them involved, to get them to sort of structure the program in a way that would be beneficial to all the programs that are participating. The biggest benefit, though, is probably for the residency applicants. We've got a time when resident applicants and programs can make rank decisions, and then the computer algorithm figures out what is the best way to try to match up programs and residents.
We have all the major equipment required for a CAMPEP accredited program. And in addition to that, we have our Proton Center. And so residents, as part of, in their third year of the residency program, they rotate through the Proton Center. They get training both on the treatment delivery process and the treatment planning process.
I did grad school in medical physics and came from a CAMPEP accredited program, so I already had quite a bit of background in the area and had taken all of the required coursework. I already have a strong base knowledge of the field, which allowed me to spend a little bit more time perhaps on clinical projects or being involved in other aspects during residency.
I got my PhD in nuclear physics at Yale University. Then after that, I worked a few years in the industry. Then I got a lot of interest in medical physics, and I found Mayo, which offers pretty nice program and also offers the certification program for the candidates without the medical physics backgrounds. So that's why I joined the medical physics match to the program here.
I think working with colleagues that aren't coming from the classical CAMPEP accredited programs is a really strong aspect of our program. Everyone brings in different viewpoints and skill sets that complement each other to really make our clinic better.
I think that Rochester is a small growing city, but it's very diverse and it has a lot of brilliant people, very educated people from all over the world. That's an amazing thing for such a small city. It has very affordable living. We enjoy the benefits of a small city. We still have very easy access to the metro life.
Personally, I love it. It's a very nice city to live in terms of when we're starting a family. You have very good schools, you have areas, you have different parks.
There aren't that many places where you can live on an acreage and still only have a 20-minute commute. So I'd say for our medical physics residents, they get the benefit of living in town, a 5-minute commute and affordable cost of living.
When I finished my residency, I was looking for jobs and I had an opportunity to go to a big metropolitan city. I decided to stay because first, I mean, I love to work here and all the people and all the teams that I've been working with. And second, very importantly, was that it allows me to have that work-life balance.
Take a look at all the different procedures that we have, all the different unique distribution of procedures and patients that we have is something that you're not going to get at many other institutions.